and welcome to this channel. This video is an introduction to how to use a breadboard. This is a breadboard and it allows you to build electronic circuits by pushing different electronic components into the holes. Today we'll make a simple circuit to demonstrate how to work with a breadboard. Let's take a closer look at the breadboard. The holes of a breadboard allows you to easily push the legs of a component into them. Breadboard has columns labeled from A to J and rows from 1 to 30. This may depend on the size of your breadboard. There are also long strips on either side of your breadboard that are labeled with red and blue colors and a plus or minus sign. These are called buses or rails. They are used to deliver power to your entire circuit. The red one marked with the plus sign will connect the positive battery terminal, and the minus sign or the blue one will connect to the negative battery terminal. Now let's connect different components to the breadboard to light an LED. To perform this experiment, you need a breadboard, a battery pack, a resistor, and an LED. The battery pack's red lead is connected to the power bus on the right side of the breadboard. This is connected to a jumbo wire, which then goes to the LED. This then goes to the row 5 on the other side to the resistor. This is then connected to the battery pack's black lead. The flow of electricity starts from the battery pack's red lead to the yellow wire, to the LED, to the resistor, and then to the battery pack's black lead. On each separate half of the breadboard, the holes in row 5 are electrically connected to each other. Now we'll switch on the battery and the light starts to glow. Try using different LEDs. Notice that all the holes in row 5 are connected electrically to each other. So even if we move the LED, to a different hole, it still lights up. That is, if we move the LED to a hole in the same row. But if I move the LED to a different row, it does not get lit up. This is because the path in which the electricity flow is now cut. It has to be in row 5 to have the complete path. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, don't forget to share, like, and subscribe.